Get set for a spectacular night of cosmic theatre. Australia is in prime position to see a rare blood moon eclipse tonight, the last total lunar eclipse until 2025.
Now, the good news is that for many of us, it will be a family-friendly eclipse, because the best part of the show will begin before 9 p.m. And joining us now from Canberra is our favourite space nerd, astrophysicist and cosmologist extraordinaire, Dr. Brad E. Tucker. E's for Elton, that's why he's our rocket man. nice to see you again. So should we be getting out the crystals then, Brad?
Look, if you want, you can howl at the moon, you can dress up accordingly, or you can go outside and enjoy it. It's going to be a fun affair. As you said, it should be family-friendly, happening just after sunset, for the most part, local time. And the great thing about a lunar eclipse or a blood moon is you don't need any special equipment. So you don't need a telescope or binoculars or safety glasses. Obviously, if you have a telescope, that's great. But you don't need it. You just need your eyes and a somewhat clear view to the east to enjoy it.
So what is a lunar eclipse, and how is it different to a total eclipse?
So a total lunar eclipse is just that the moon passes into the Earth's shadow. Mm-hmm. So the Earth casts a shadow out into space and the moon goes into it. Now, when we get a total solar eclipse, the moon passes in front of the sun between the Earth. So tonight, the moon will be passing into that shadow the Earth casts. And so as it does it, it will turn darker. In fact, it'll start to look Pac-Man-like, where bits of it are missing. And then when it's fully in the shadow, it's going to turn this red color. That's the blood color we reference.
Oh.
That's actually because a little bit of sunlight skims the Earth's atmosphere, goes off into space, and then lights up the moon. So you're essentially seeing sunrise and sunset of Earth lighting up the moon 380,000 kilometers away, producing a beautiful show.
Wow.
It's the last one for a long time. 2025, yeah. The next one we'll see.
That's right. So you definitely will have to wait a few years. It's the sort of thing that, you know, you will see again. But, yeah, you do have to wait a few years if you miss this one. And as you said, the rarity bit of it, I think, is that it's at a family-friendly time. Half the things in astronomy, you know, it's 2 a.m., 3 a.m., this starts right after sunset.
All right, still might be steep for me, Brad. I might be in bed by then. but come here. The fact that it's not happening in 2025, it gives NASA a bit more time to start looking for UFOs. Or as they refer to them as UAPs. How are they conducting that study?
That's right. So UAPs is the new terminology for UFOs. And that's because UFOs is unidentified flying objects. And that kind of implies it's a physical thing. UAPs, unidentified aerial phenomenon, means that it could just be something. And what NASA is saying, and this is off the back of the U.S. Defense Department, is we kind of need to study this in detail. We have a lot of data. People are observing this, but we're not really studying it. We don't know how to say what is what. So this panel's been put together to say, this is how you study UAPs. This is what this could be, or this is what this could not be. You know, essentially, we've been seeing images, and we just don't know what to do. We don't know what things are, unless it's just unidentified. So trying to put a bit of the mystery behind it and really show what are the things that we don't know, so that we can focus on the things that may be of interest, potentially life or potentially just other earthly technology.
Well, UAPs does sound better, though, doesn't it?
No, UFOs sounds heaps better.
Yeah, but you're still, but now there's a way for them to say, yeah, there is UFOs. See what I'm saying?
I do see what you're saying. Hey, Brad, I feel like there's a lot of weird juju around. I don't know if it's a scientific thing. It's just a vibe I've got. Bit of a vibe. There's some weird juju. Do you believe that the moon does cause that? Because I've seen studies that heart attacks, for example, spike around full moons and things like that. Does the moon and a big moon like this, a blood moon, make us all a bit cuckoo?
So look, one of the things with the... So a total lunar eclipse always happens at a full moon, so it'll be a full moon tonight. And so a full moon, by definition, rises at sunset. So people notice the full moon because it's always low in the sky at a time they're out. Mm. And so often then we're sometimes distracted. People have looked at motorcycle accidents, for instance. Now, we do know there are some physical effects. For instance, coral growth changes due to a full moon and the phases of the moon. Some people often have looked at criminology. Are there more activity or more incidences happening with the full moon? Partly that is because the sky's a bit brighter. right? If you go on to, you know, you go in the middle of the night where there's no moon, it's really dark. But on the full moon, you can actually see a little bit more, so it's more likely to have people out. So it's more a factor of maybe the lighting and our distraction rather than the moon itself. So I think it's more of a, we need an excuse to go cuckoo rather than the moon making us go cuckoo.
Yeah, that's
July 11, you said your birthday was, right? That's spoken like a true Cancerian, if you ask me. Dr. Brad E. Tucker.
Enjoy today.
Enjoy tonight.
You must be buzzing.
I will enjoy today, you enjoy tonight, and if you want, just howl and let it rip tonight.
Oh, yeah, of course. Happy early
that
Christmas,
the
Brad.
That is scientific advice. Howl and let it rip. Thank you, Doc. We'll see you soon.
See ya.